would like to read out the bio sketch of our beloved principal, Sir Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra. A dream does not become reality through magic. It takes sweat, determination, and hard work. So this is the motto of our beloved principal, Sir Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra, a recognized academician and educational administrator with the objective of producing the highest echelon of technocrats. His area of interest includes artificial intelligence, software engineering, data mining and warehousing, and wireless network. Professor has several achievements on his name. He is recipient of Governor Award for 3 times, Rashtriya Gaurav Award, Rashtriya Vikas Ratan Award, Dronacharya Award, Young Leader 2019, IBAE International Award Dubai. He has received Rs 86 lakh funds from DST, IIT Bombay and AICTE. He is also a recipient of consultancy project worth Rs 444 crores from GHMC Hyderabad and 31 lakhs from UGC. He has facilitated 300 Akash tablets from IIT Bombay. He has published 24 patents, 12 books, and more than 88 international and national research papers, 16 magazine articles, and 138 newspaper coverages. He is active member of ISCE, CI, technical advisor to Alexia Japan, and many more. Recently, he has been honored as an advisor to NAC, Bengaluru, UGC Paramarsh, National Cyber Safety and Security Standards, Government of India. Sir has delivered several guest lectures in different parts of the country, and he is also a visiting corporate trainer for many software organizations. He goes as an invited speaker for higher education conferences organized by Telangana State Council of Higher Education and World Education Summit. His guidance to all the departments and dedication towards the work has taken our institution to heights. Now, may I request our beloved principal, Sir Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra, to address the participants. Over to you, sir.
So thank you, Snehalata Madam, for a brief introduction about me. So first of all, respected Chairman, Sri M. Lakshman Reddy, sir, respected Executive Director, Sri G. Chandrasekhar Yadav, sir, Chief Guest of today's program, Mr. Dave from Bold Enterprise, USA, and Dr. Kishanjit Kumar Khatua, who is the Professor of Civil Engineering Department from NIT Rourkela, and convener of this program, Professor Sandhya Kiran, co-convener, Dr. Gyanaranjan Khuntia, and all the program coordinator, advisory committee members, deans, HODs, invited guests, other speakers, and students, and last but not the least, participant across the country and across the other across the world, a very good morning to all of you. So I am Dr. Santosh Kumar Patra, principal of St. Martin Engineering College. Wholeheartedly, I would like to welcome you to this 3 days international workshop, which is titled as Intellectual Property Rights and Innovations in Civil Engineering Department, which is scheduled from today, and it will be there for tomorrow and day after tomorrow. At the outset, first, I would like to congratulate the Civil Engineering Department for getting 444 crore consultancy project from GHMC, Government of Telangana, which is a remarkable achievement. And I would like to congratulate the Department of Civil Engineering for getting the consultancy project from HMWSSB, which is worth of 50 crore rupees again, the Government of Telangana. Again, the second congratulation goes to you. And at third, I would like to congratulate and appreciate the department for taking a lot of interest of bringing out these innovative plans and activities during this pandemic and thinking for the society to enlighten every individuals to have a good knowledge, not only on academics, in different verticals too. So as per my knowledge goes, I think within a year, this is your 9th or 10th event. So almost every month there is an event from Civil Engineering Department. So I am very happy to be a part of all of your event, and I have witnessed all of your past 9 events are mega success, and I wish this event also you will make it very grand and very big success. So my sincere appreciation to Professor Sandhya Kiran and her entire dynamic team who worked very hard to bringing this idea into this reality. And again, I would like to appreciate and sincerely thank, and I would like to welcome Mr. Dave. Already we had met once and we are very happy to see you here, sir, again. And we miss you and my faculty members too, because you had come and you had taken a session for my student and faculty. Because of the pandemic, at least we were able to interact and see you. And I would like to thank you very much for accepting our invitation and given your consent to be with us and enlighten us with your knowledge. And secondly, I would like to appreciate and thanks to Dr. Kishanjit Kumar Khatua, sir. With a short notice, I came to know, sir has agreed. And even though in this pandemic also, sir is very busy with a lot of academic, administrative and research work, because based on my knowledge goes, sir is already dealing with 5 number of sponsored project and more than 3 number of consultancy project. And sir is having already 15 students, those who are pursuing PhD under him. So I could able to understand what type of workload sir will be having. But we are really thankful to you, sir, that you have given respect to our invitation and agreed. And you have given your kind consent to be with us. We really appreciate and we are really grateful to your gesture. So, and this title, it is quite interesting and it is quite innovative, because the title, it is talking about intellectual property rights and innovation in civil engineering. So whenever there is a concept called innovation in civil engineering, first we should like to remember that for earlier days when we talk about engineering, there was only one engineering, that is civil engineering. After that, all these flavors and varieties have come. Else the olden days, so civil engineering is, somebody need not have to specify that I am a civil engineer. That's all, they have to say that I am an engineer, and by default it will be treated and understood that they are belongs to civil engineering. And always civil engineering plays a great role for all these types of constructions, because I could able to remember my childhood days where we used to see the asbestos sheets were used to construct the house. And finally, it has been migrated and people started putting the slabs. Then multi-storied buildings came and the era has continued in such a way that now there is a talk and there are evidences where people were talking about the signature buildings. As I could able to see, the L&T head office is there. What a beautiful structure it is. It is no way with the bricks and cements. It's the renovation and the beauty of the building is so phenomenal. So they have a style of addressing it as a signature building. Now I had come across one more building. That is the Tata Consultancy Service building, which is located at Chennai Sipcot area. The building completely looks like a butterfly. If from far away you will see the building, it doesn't look like a building, it looks like a butterfly. So that is the level and that is the way the civil engineering department has grown phenomenally and shown all this outcomes and beautiful structures and given for the mankind. So there are continuously a lot of innovations are happening, and recently I was going through some of the articles where I am very fascinated to read about some of the development of civil engineering. That is one of the concept is self-healing concrete. See, whenever we talk about construction, there is a issue about the cracks, and civil engineering talks about various cracks like horizontal cracks, vertical cracks, and there are a lot of impact analysis why these cracks have come. Okay, so that is one path. But one scientist and some of the civil engineers have decided to come out with a concept of self-healing concrete. And how it works? So they have developed a self-healing concrete by using a mix containing a bacteria with a microcapsule, which will aid building innovations by germinating when water enters a crack into the concrete to produce limestone, and plugging the crack before water and oxygen has a chance to corrode the steel and reinforced. So what sort of beautiful innovations the civil engineers are doing? Again, I was reading some of the article and I came to know about it. There is a concept called green roof system. And I was also reading some of the interesting article where I came to know that, no, the floating homes are designed by the civil engineers. And there are, nowadays, there are talk about the self-sustainable green buildings. Means, whatever the walls are there, that is not the traditional walls. So, that is mounted with the solar panels. So, whatever the requirement of electricity to run the house, that should be self-generated. What a beautiful concept the civil engineers are doing. And always, that is why this branch is so excited and interested and demand for all the decades. So I really congratulate all the people, those who have chosen their career to become a civil engineering. And there are a lot of interesting and innovations that we are going to discuss today, tomorrow, and the day after tomorrow with all these experts from academia and industry, from nationally to international level. And the title, as it suggests, about the concept of intellectual property rights. See, we might be hearing about intellectual property rights. We might be hearing about a concept called trademark. We will be hearing about the concept called copyrights, patents, design, trade secrecy. So a lot of confusions are there. What is intellectual property rights? Then somebody is talking about trademark, somebody is talking about intellectual property rights, somebody is talking about copyrights. So let me put it in a very simple way and let us understand intellectual property right. It is an umbrella that covers number of different rights. And what are all different rights? The trademark, copyrights, patents, design, trade secrecy. All these things are under the umbrella of intellectual property rights. So in this FDP, in this workshop, for 3 days, we will be talking about all these things in a detailed manner. So in addition to that, in earlier days, it was not that important to go for an intellectual property rights, and for it is not the everybody's cup of tea also, because it is a time-consuming process, lot of documentations, and it is also cost is also involved into it. And there might not be any necessity. But now, as we are witnessing, okay, if we do not have any web presence in the sense in the internet world, if our presence is not there, then survival and succeeding in any business is next to impossible. So to make our presence across the globe in the internet, we need to have the intellectual property rights. We need to have our copyrights registered. If we have done that, then we can claim the ownership. And the ownership of copyright and intellectual property rights are quite interesting, like the ownership what we hold for other assets. Let's say we have a land. How? We are the owner. Similarly, in copyrights and intellectual property rights also, we will be the owner. So being a owner of the land, we have the ability and we have the rights to sell it, to rent it, to share it, or to transfer it to the relatives or to the generation. Same thing, we can do it to the intellectual property rights also. So it is a lifetime assets which gives us the revenue for 3 different generations. So all these things in detail, all the different expert members will be talking. So again, at the outset, I would like to congratulate the department as well as to all the participants to have a very good learning. And I wanted to put a small note to the participant. Please make use of this, all these efforts, whatever all gone into the system to bring out the best from academia as well as industry for you all. And finally, it should increase your knowledge matrix, and we need to disseminate the knowledge whatever we have achieved for the benefit of the society. And before I sign out, I would like to again wholeheartedly thanks to Mr. Dev and as well as Dr. Kishanjit sir for kindly given their consent and be with us for the program. Thank you very much, and thank you for the opportunity. Have a great day ahead. Thank you.